Okay, this is Jojo's super quick and nasty cover tutorial for the MF-er who wants to record a song but doesn't really know how. I'm not gonna go through a bunch of details. I'm gonna just blow through the chorus and record a song the way I would record it to get a rough draft that you can build upon and refine over time and make good. Oh, I guess also for step one. Hello, YouTube. Step two, get like an audio interface hooked up and with sound coming through it. And then once you do that, get Reaper. And then once you get that, save a project called whatever you want. We're gonna do Bob Seger, still the same. We have Reaper and it's open. We're gonna make a bunch of tracks and we're gonna fill them up with stuff. So you can just click and make tracks. You can also group tracks together by holding shift and clicking. Click on one, hold shift, click it, and then you can drag them into a group. So we'll do one that's vocals. We'll do one that is boop. One's that guitar. And we'll click on the first one, we'll hold shift, we'll click on the last one. We will color them yellow for vocals, and we will color them green for guitars. I'm gonna turn off all these monitoring things because that's not what I want. This button is something you should fuck around with and figure out how it works, though. I'm gonna pan one of them in the middle. I'm gonna pan one of them to the left. I'm gonna pan one of them to the right. And with the guitar, I'm just gonna do left and right. And then, well, fuck it, we'll keep the middle one too. You can drag these around, okay? So I'll usually label them like this, like center, left, right. Usually for guitars, it'll just be left and right. But we're also going to do a scratch take. So we're going to copy and paste another one, and we're going to do another one. Scratch take. Okay. You also need a metronome. And if you right-click the metronome, you can change where the, and then you click this thing. You can then choose where your metronome goes out. I send my metronome to a specific channel, but basically, get a metronome working so that when you press space, you hear a click. Okay, now you can hear my click track. First, we have to find the tempo of the song. So, sometimes you can get lucky and you can just like Google it and type like into Google, Bob Seger, still the same BPM. And this thing just says, it says 116. So, I'm just gonna type in 116. Down here, you click. Okay, you can either play this song in your headphones or something and tap this button along, and it'll change with the tempo. So now the click will be really fast. Or you can click slower. One, two, three, four, one, two. And it'll eventually figure out what the BPM is. You can also click on the number and change it. So it says it's 116. I'm gonna listen to the song and click along. Yes, yeah, 116 seems to be working. So, I'm gonna listen to the song in my headphones and I'm gonna play along on my guitar. I'm going to sing along and record it just so I have it in the computer so I can like see what it's supposed to look like, kind of. Also, I didn't do this properly. You gotta change your inputs to your microphone. So, these are input one for your mic. And input two for my guitar. You can change multiple things at once by holding shift and clicking on multiple things. So these guitars are in the guitar group. These vocals are in the vocal group. Oh yeah, I also get like very organized in my chord sheets. So you also need to be able to play the song all the way through in order for this to work. So make sure you do that. And at first, you don't need to have the click track on. While you're recording, you just play along to the CD or the album or the fucking Spotify or whatever the fuck. YouTube. Play along to the song. Start recording.
You always won every time you play. To bed, you still down. to you, yeah.
Also, it doesn't matter if it's like correct.
Every time they were sure they had you caught.
All right. Now we officially have a scratch take with the entire song. Now, the tricky part. The song is now in here, so we have a general idea. The only reason we did this is so we have like a visual guide. We can just mute this and mute that. It doesn't really matter now. We are going to kind of ignore that for a second and now do a new scratch take. Now you got two things armed. Now we're going to play along to the click track and try to play the entire song in time to this click track. And basically just play the song again and actually try to do it well. This is a speed run. But it's not going to be perfect at first. It'll get perfect over time. That accomplished is basically now we can see the original. We can click on the original take, the original scratch take, click on and hold control. So now you're clicked on both of them. So now you can move them, and you just want to slide them to match where the new take is, and then you can maybe go to the solo and make sure that you played the solo for the right amount of time. Basically, this is a guide to help you organize all the song parts. Because you might play one part that's too short. You might miss a fill somewhere. If you have a scratch take that is the original song, you can at least visually see, like, okay, the intro is supposed to be this long. The bridge is this long. The ending is this long. You know, you can just see it now. Also, since we did it to the click track. One, two, three. Now we can play new versions on top of them and make them better. And we're just gonna record more tracks now. One, two. Might notice that it sounds like shit. I'll teach you how to okay, so you hit this FX thing. You can put different effects on tracks. You can do them individually or you can do it on the group. So I'm gonna go on this vocal group. I'm gonna look for a re-EQ. There's so many things though. Just type in EQ. And then now these are all the EQs. The ones that are built into Reaper are all start with REA, so re-compressor, re-delay, re-EQ, there it is. Click on this. Okay, so now we've got an equalizer on this group. So, I'm just gonna throw high pass filters on shit. So click this, high pass.
You always won.
And that will clear up a little bit of those bassy. Oh.
Phase one.
Listen.
Every time you place a bet, you're still damn good. No one's gotten to you.
So fuck around with a high pass filter or a low cut filter and also add one to the guitar. That just makes the guitar and the vocal sound a little bit clearer so you don't have all those bass tones going on. Frequencies, rather. The name of the game is Get a better take than the first take, and then stack them together, panned to the left, and then one panned to the right, and then it'll start sounding marginally good. One, two, three, one. those all sound like shit still, but if you play them and you pan, if you drag this divider, more shit will show up. So, like these pan things, if you hide them away, you can't see them. But you crank one to the left, crank one to the right, so now you've got vocals. Oh, boop. You can drag stuff around. You can also hold right click, and you can select stuff this way. If you hold left click, it's a different type of selector. Right click, left click, escape. Okay, also, you should be saving your projects. Now, this muted scratch track is just a guide, but it looks like I'm playing it the right way because they're the same length. I basically can just delete them now. Because already the hardest part, which is getting the song's format into there, is already done. So we've already, like, gotten a lot of shit done. It might not sound good yet, though. I'm going to delete the original scratch takes now. Delete. Delete. We're going to play it. Turn off the click track. Up here.
You always won every time you placed a bet. You're still damn good. No one's gotten to you yet.
Okay, so now it's just a matter of refining shit. I'm going to copy these vocals, I'm going to paste them, I'm going to delete them. Now I've got a new vocal area, I'm going to name it background vocals. Because at the end it goes like this.
Baby, baby, still the same. Still the same.
Still the same.
Baby, baby, still the same. Game again.
Still the same.
Still the same, baby, baby, still the same.
All right, do that another time.
Have to say, cause we're still the same.
Still the same,
baby, baby, still the same. Still the same.
Still the same,
baby, baby, still the same. Still the same, baby, baby, still the same. Still the same, baby, baby, still the same.
Are you still the same?
Still the same, baby, baby, still the same. Still the same.
Still the same,
baby, baby, still the same.
Now we can not play guitar, record a vocal take right down the middle. So this will be the center vocal take. Turn the click track back on if you want. I would. Just record it again.
You always won. Every time you placed a bet, you're still damn good. No one's gotten to you yet.
So now we have the acoustic guitars poorly played. We have the vocals left, right, and center poorly sang. And we've got the background vocals left and right also poorly sang. We'll delete this center one. And the song is technically recorded now, but what I would do is I would re-record these guitars and try to play them well. I would re-record all these vocals, try to play them well. You just keep retrying and re-recording. You can add as many tracks as you want. Add some bass. Add some fucking electric guitar, add some flute, add whatever the hell you want, stick it in front of a microphone and record it. This is like the building blocks have been laid. You're playing to a click track, so it's all to the grid. So if you want to add new parts, shift them around, it's very easy. If you don't play to a grid, your life's just going to be a nightmare. And if you have like a band and you're playing all together and you don't have a metronome, that's fine, maybe. But if you're all alone and you're trying to record multiple parts, use a fucking click track. I honestly think that's it. That's like, if you can get that far, then it's just a matter of refining things and learning how to use like vocal effects and guitar effects and mixing and all sorts of shit. But if you can just get the fucking song down, that's the first hard part. It can sound like total shit, but if it's the whole song and it's in, you're like ahead of the curve. So good job. Okay, here's the thing, you guys. I need to go roller skating. So please follow and like and subscribe. And also, hit the bell for that notifications, you pieces of shit. Tutorial over.